just alone. I place my trust and find my glory in the power of the cross. In every victory, let it be said of me, my source of strength. Welcome to our Hope in Christ program. In today's episode, we will talk about the art of listening. This is something that we all should cultivate in our lives. But before we continue with this topic, let's come to the Lord in a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you that today we can talk about the art of listening, where we can learn from your word and from others who have learned to cultivate this art and prove to be effective listeners themselves. Help us, Lord, to communicate this beautiful truth to the audience today, and may we all be guided by the wisdom of your word as we study this art of listening together. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. So the art of listening, and today we have the privilege to have with me a very special guest. She's a person closest to my life, none other than my wife, Eleanor. So welcome, sweetie, sa ating program about the art of listening. What can you say to our audience?
Thank you. Thank you so much, Pastor Jun, for inviting me to be part of this program, and good day to you all. I pray that you are good hands, you're in good condition at this time.
Okay, so the art of listening. The Bible actually has this verse for us to consider. That's in James chapter 1 verse 19, no? James 1 verse 19, it says, "My dear brothers, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry." Everyone, he said, take note of this. Everyone, so nobody is exempted. Not me, nor you who are watching the show now, nor my wife Eleanor. All of us are told everyone should be quick to listen. Quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. So the Bible really teaches us to be quick in listening. Why is that so? To be quick to listen. Now, you notice, of course, that God has given us two ears and only one mouth. So that in itself reminds us that we should listen twice more than we speak, you know? So, listening. So far sa atong relationship, do we have problem in listening to one another?
Yeah, I think in the exempted bisan ng mga couples in marriages, that is not able to listen to each other well is one reason why there are conflicts in relationships. Somebody said, it is really true and real that most people can hear, but only very few are capable or of really listening.
Listening. Now, I think isang important distinction generally between a man and a woman is that men listen with our minds, no? We analyze, we think, while women tend to listen with their hearts, trying to pick up the feelings behind what is being said. Given that situation alone, that's why we can see that there's a potential for misunderstanding or mishearing the other party, especially when it's a man and a woman involved. So cultivating that art of listening, do you agree with that? That most likely women will try to listen with their hearts more than men, who would like to rather analyze
the situation?
Well, because women are more inclined to building relationships.
Mm-hmm.
And good listening, good those who listen well, build relationship.
Mm-hmm.
We talk because we want to be understood.
Mm-hmm.
And listening seeks to understand.
Uh-huh.
So the more you listen, the more you will understand. And that person, and when you feel that you are being understood, you feel good, you feel mm-hmm. better. So we seek to understand when we listen more.
Yeah. But although ang mga lalaki, like ako siguro, when we speak to each other, especially if what is being discussed is like a problem, we are wired in such a way that while you are speaking, we are already thinking how to solve the problem. We're thinking about solution. How do we solve this problem? How do we get rid of this problem? Whereas women, at times, ang tendency is you just would like to open up your heart, just seeking to be understood. But sometimes our agenda is not really to understand you, but to see how can we help you by solving that problem. So oftentimes there will be some kind of miscommunication because of that difference in our listening tendencies, no? So listening to one another with using a different medium. Now, of course, through the ears, and then for the men, ears to the mind. So yun naman, ears to the heart. But this could be viewed as a conflict, but at the same time, it can also be seen as a compliment, no? Compliment, where we can approach the situation in a way nga hindi lang mental analysis, kundi even what are the feelings behind. So I've noticed that si Eleanor has been reading many books, especially in the area of counseling. Who has been these authors who seem to impact you the most?
Well, John Maxwell, I'm reading this book on relationships, Building Relationship by John Maxwell. And I can share with you some of the values he's sharing here on listening. One is, number one, he said, listening shows respect.
Mm-hmm.
Most of us would talk a lot. We seek to be and to make people be interested to us. You want to impress by the many things we say, that we somehow communicate to them that we learn, we know a lot. But why are we like that? When we seek to really minister to people, especially leaders, no, those who are in authority, managers, we want people to be impressed, to respect us. But no, the more we talk and we don't listen to them, we don't really earn the respect. We earn respect more by being interested, communicating to them that we're interested to them. Not because us impressing them, but us impressed of them. So listening develops or earns respect.
Yeah. Interestingly, before coming to the studio today, I was actually listening to Donald Trump, this candidate for presidency in the United States of America. And Donald Trump is more of a talker than a listener. In fact, he would, when he speaks, it's so rapid. He speaks so rapidly, and the tendency is once he's able to pick up some attack against him, his mind is just so quick to respond immediately to counter-attack. No? Parang ganun. And by doing this, many people are impressed because they said, oh, he's a smart guy. Look at him. Some, especially the politicians, may think that it's by trying to dominate the talk that they become impressive to others. I think temporarily it may achieve that purpose, but in the long run, maybe it's counterproductive, no?
Well, if you are in that kind of a situation that you are asked to speak, and then so you're in the platform, you take time, you make the most of that to speak your mind to whatever is needed. But in building relationships, in ministering, even in relating to your spouse or relating to your children, we have to learn this art. We have to really know the value of listening. One author said, Dale Carnegie said, big people monopolizes listening. Small people monopolize talking.
Mm-hmm.
Big people monopolize listening.
Mm-hmm.
Small people monopolize talking.
So it looks like I'm a small person. I must be monopolizing a lot of talking. That's what it means.
Yeah, when you want just to talk and you don't really seek to know what's going on and what these people around you need.
Mm.
Especially some particular people who need help,
yeah.
Who are asking for your time.
Yeah, of course it's not the physical size that's being measured, no? But what is being measured between the bigness and the smallness of these people in relation to listening is their mind, no? Their capability to really understand and respond to situations. So far, have you been listening yourselves? It looks like Eleanor Dere has been talking and listening at the same time. But it looks like para sa atong mga audience, perhaps you were mostly doing the listening. But if you want to talk back and communicate with us, feel free to connect with us. You can call our landline or text us in our cell phones. Later on, you will see the numbers plus there. We would be happy to listen to you too, so that somehow we will be able to get your points of view. So listening, not the art of listening. The Bible said, be quick to listen and slow to speak. Do you like people who are very slow in speaking? Like saying, did you finish the homework?
That's not what the Bible means. No, it means that hindi ka agad-agad magkasabat o mag-interrupt o hindi ka magdasig-dasig, basta na lang kamahambal.
Right.
Maminsar ka, anay, pamatian mo, anay, kung ano gid bala ang gusto ihambal o ano gid bala ang gusto niya i-communicate.
Uh-huh.
You know, because a good listener has more knowledge, and he increases his knowledge more. When he seeks to listen more, he understands better. And especially in a counseling situation, he or she can be more effective.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a funny thing happens, or maybe sad thing happens. Kung kita nga mga managers or mga even parents, you know, kung hindi kita kabalo mamati, ang mga tao ta, mga anak ta, will find other ears to listen, other people to listen to them. And so, wala, dito na sila. And so we are not able to know anymore what's happening to them, and when kung may problema sila, we're not able to help better or maybe prevent more problems because sa ibang sila nagsugit sa ilang problema instead na kita, and we are able to address better their needs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're talking about the art of listening, no? How do you really cultivate that maximizing of the listening skills? And I think there are some practical tips to do that, no? If you really want to listen, you look at the person straight to the eyes. The one who is speaking, look to that person who is speaking to you. Kaya ang masubok is, nga samtang nagahambal ka, naga-text ko ya. Naga-text ko, sige lang, blambala, dahil ka pamati ko. Naga-text ni ganing, iban, nga tanaw TV, samtang gahambal ka. When people do that, actually, that's an indication nga why siya ga-concentrate, most likely, hindi niya mabatian carefully kung what is being communicated. Especially if you miss looking at the eyes. No?
That's very important, sweetheart. In counseling, we summarize it with the letter solar, S-O-L-E-R. These are tips in really cultivating and listening skills. So S would be sit squarely, straight, so you can make him, the person, feel that you're really interested. Then O is just open, nothing in between, no tables there. And L, when the person speaks, you lean a little towards the person. Of course, not to, don't do that way because, So you're interested. You really want to listen. You want to know what is it. And I and E, that's the eye contact. Look at the eyes, but be careful how you look at the eyes. Of course, sometimes some people are not really comfortable looking at the eyes for a long time.
Especially kung opposite sex is involved.
Yes. And R, solar, S-O-L-E-R. R is relax. Just relax. Don't be so. Sometimes tense ka or parabang kung galit siya, kung subuan siya, kung nagahibi siya, galain ka kung ano nang ginahimu mo, pang ginakaptan ka. So just maintain your composure. Mm-hmm. S, sit squarely at tubangon mo gitang person. O,
open.
Between you, it's open. Wala sang table as much as possible. L, a little leaning forward. E, eye contact. And R, relax. Guard your emotions. Guard yourself not to be reactive. Listen more. Okay.
Yeah. Of course, when you talk about listening, you don't just listen to the words, no? You can even listen to the non-verbal messages that are being communicated. Sa mga psychologists, may certain percentage sila about trying to understand the person. May percentage ang words, may percentage ang non-verbal nga may percentage ang manner, the way the words were said, no? Kag may ara pa siya nga mga actions kisa. So, it takes a lot of discipline to really listen, no? And seek to understand the other person.
And you have to be careful on your interruptions. Minimize interruptions. Find the intervals where you can pause and ask for clarifications or repeat, summarize what he or she has said. Kung anong nahambal niya. Para bago siya magpadayon na mas naintindihan mo ang portion nga una niya ginhambal. So, repeat mo, amuni ang but masilingon. Masilingon na late ka subong kay ang bata mo nagdalagan kag nadus mo. So, git po jut mo, anay, kag niya si kaso. Ano pa na late ka? Kag nga, wala ka subong, wae ka makatawag na yun, kay ang imo nga cellphone na buyan mo. Wae mo na at si kaso.
Yeah. Although, na-notice ko, so far, ang trend sa ato nga discussion is more on parang sa formal counseling setup, no? But I think ang pinaka-importanting day-to-day nga ginagamit, more than the counseling setup, is normal conversation, no? When you know how to listen to the one speaking to you, whether anak sa parent, or mag-asawa, or friend to friend, or customer to merchandiser, mga munabla yung pag-uusap na ganyan. So, na-notice ko, nga kisa, may mga tao nga bungol nga ka-istoryana eh. Nakakita ka na sang bungol nga duha sila, bungol, pero ka-istoryana sila.
Nasinggita na sila. They shout at each other.
Sometimes not even shouting, they just don't listen at all. No? Lalo na kung medyo may conflict, may argument, lain ang point sa piyak, lain ang point sa piyak. Ga-istorya ang mga bungol.
Oo. No? Bira-bira siya hambal sa iyang points. Bira-bira man niya ang isa. Uh-oh. Ang ila lang niya yung aim is ihambal kung anong ila nga sa mind nila. Hmm. Why sila kapamati? Paano na... Like, why nila nakita ang ano di ba lang? Parang... ano tawag siya? Wala. It doesn't serve the purpose. Kaya hindi ka, lang. Why man siya kapamati? Nga sa ika na hambal. What for?
Yeah. Actually, there are two scenarios in ano, nga ka-istorya ang mga bungol. Una, dungan sila hambal. So kung dungan hambal, kahambal lang siya, kahambal man ang isa, why gina sa nabatian niya? Ikaduha, it is also possible nga gahambal ka, hipos lang ko, pero wala ko ginapamatian ang ginahambal mo tungod kay ang pinsar kuya, how to refute you, how to highlight your mistakes, paano ka supuhin sa mga inconsistencies mo, yung ganun. Again, that's another crisis of understanding where people simply don't know how to listen.
And so we don't understand, we don't change, we are not able to help each other. Kakita man, we are not helped kung anong kinahanglan ta because we don't listen. And we don't wait for them. At times, we just talk, we don't wait for others to listen.
Isa
pa sa mga teachers, sometimes, kita nga mga teachers, gaginahod ang aton nga mga estudyante. They are talking to each other. And we have very important points to share. We are to teach them these things and this subject matter. But if they're not listening, what for? You have to do something to make them listen. So that you can get your points across and they will be helped.
Yeah. Interestingly, it's hard to listen when the atmosphere is so noisy, no? That's why even in that classroom setting, maayo ginakis ang teacher, in order to be heard, is not to shout louder, but simply to be quiet and look at the kids. And eventually, they get the point that they are supposed to stop talking. So, nami man ang mga issues about listening, no? But you know, when we talk about listening, no? We want the kind of listening that can actually help the one who listens to, no? Sometimes we listen because we desire to understand and help the other person. But there is a kind of listening that when you listen carefully, it will be actually your life that will be changed and transformed. And the Bible speaks about that, no? Let me read again in James chapter 1, verse 22 and 23. It says, "Do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says. Anyone who listens to the word but does not do what it says is like a man who looks at his face in a mirror and after looking at himself goes away and immediately forgets what he looks like. But the man who looks intently into the perfect law that gives freedom and continues to do this, not forgetting what he has heard, but doing it, he will be blessed in what he does." And so, siling diri sa aton, listening, this is how to listen. Don't just listen with your ears, but learn to listen with all your heart, with all your mind, soul, no? So that when you listen, you are supposed to apply what is being taught. Now, especially in relation to the Bible, no? In relation to the Bible. Now, of course, you read the Bible if you are doing it yourself. Or in a church, there is a sermon. Somebody is preaching. The word of God is being preached. The Bible said, do not merely listen. When the Bible says merely listen, it's like, it enters here and then you forget about it. The Bible said, do not merely listen because if you do, you will just deceive yourself. You should do what it says. So, kinahanglan, ginahimo. Amo na yung listening niya, the kind of listening that transforms you as a listener, that you become a better person. You become a person who pleases God, who becomes relevant and helpful even to other people because you yourself has been changed. So, kanami actually sang listening, no? Nang gapamati ka, Pero in this world, ano ang pinakananamian mo pamatian? Is it music? Is it kutso-kutso? Is it good preaching, teaching material? Normally, ano ba ang, like in our normal day-to-day situation, ano ang ginapamatian ta?
For me, my really most precious time with the Lord, with His Word, that's I enjoy most. Secondly, listening to you every time you preach. Pastor John is my favorite preacher.
Bias, ha? Bias. Yeah,
of course. Yeah, when I listen to you, I understand better. And in regard to the Word of God, yes, that's the value of listening. When we listen well, we don't talk, we don't argue, we just take time and think about what does really the Lord wants for me? What is it He means with this? We increase our knowledge, understanding of the Word, of the Lord's will for us, and we are able to do what is right, what is beneficial to others, what is how to obey Him, and how to lead people to the right path, how to lead people to the Lord. So if we listen more, take time with the Lord, with His Word, we are better people. Because we know how to live and how to make other people's lives better.
Listening, no? In our spiritual life, there is what we call spiritual breathing, no? Spiritual breathing, wherein we inhale by taking in the Word of God, allowing the Word of God to teach us, to transform us. And then we exhale by praying, no? Just like breathing. Inhale, oxygen, exhale, carbon dioxide. But in our spiritual walk, spiritual life, the same spiritual breathing can happen. Inhale the Word of God, you exhale by praying. Interestingly, even in praying, you can do listening, no? That's why there is what we call listening prayer. You pray to God, and yet you don't actually speak. You listen. Have you done that before, yung listening prayer?
Well, naturally, as a person, I'm not really a talker. That is why maybe I appreciate more this kind of praying. I don't know. When I start being with the Lord, I don't know what to say. I don't really know my words. I grasp for words in talking to the Lord. So I do a lot of quiet waiting on Him and asking Him, Lord, teach me. What do I say? There are so many things in my heart. There are so many things in my mind, but I don't know how to say it. And so as I take time, quiet, the silence, and just then the Lord will put those words in my heart, in my mind, and on my pen. Kasi when we encourage you to do journaling, so writing your prayer concerns, and most of the time, I do more of writing my thanksgiving, answered prayers, instead of prayer requests. Before, when I was younger, more prayer requests, less answered prayers. Now, less and less prayer requests. I just ask the Lord, Lord, teach me what to pray, how to pray, and then every time I write in my journal, I just write there, thank you, Lord, for this. You have answered these prayers. Even before I really speak and write the concerns, you have done this. And so I thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. I know to many people, it's not easy for them to do what we call listening prayer, wherein you come to the Lord because you want to pray, and yet you don't actually say anything. You are there, said, Lord, let me pray. But then you did not say a word because you were there waiting to listen to Him. And you are actually praying, no? Praying, pero listening prayer. And the good thing about it, kapag makultivate na natin ina nga klase sang listening sa Ginoo, then I think even when we relate to people later on, daw medyo ang sensitivity naton to really pick up what is being communicated to us is sharper than rather than just inabalang gapamati ka analyze lang permi pamatian ko analyze ko ni I can definitely suggest, I can advise, I know how to solve the problem. Ina nga mga approach nga ginahimo naton kis ano hindi naman talaga nakakatulong sa iban, tapos kisa hindi man nakakatulong sa aton because we deprive ourselves of learning, no, being taught. Because if you really are inclined to teach, to share your insight, be sure you know how to listen. Otherwise, what insights will you be sharing when you have not been learning? So these are important things for us to remember. We've been married for 28 years, no? Sakto?
This June.
So, and then, of course, we've been listening to each other for much longer than 28 years because we were classmates in college before, and then after graduation, we had been steady for 5 years, no? So it's been a long time, 28 plus perhaps another 8, so 36 years of sharing life together, then we should have been listening a lot from each other.
So, why ka mag-inatakan sa akong sweetheart? More than 28 years?
Well, there will always be...
Isang mga istorya kag...
There will always be new things to learn, no? And even new things to unlearn. So
yes, so many things to unlearn.
Yeah, it is by listening that you will be able to distinguish which is which. Yeah. Am I going to learn this? Or am I supposed to unlearn what I have learned in the past already?
So, abudlay mag-grow ang relationship kung hindi takabalo mamati sa isa kag-isa.
That's right.
Kinanglan gid nga i-develop tagid ni ang art of listening sa marriage relationship.
Yeah. So what are some of your parting words you'd like to say to the audience about the art of listening? What matters most to you when it comes to listening?
Siguro gusto ko lang i-encourage na we can be intentional about this in developing this art to be able to strengthen our relationships in the home, in the church, kag kundiin man. So, you know, we are leaders in wherever field you are. You can be leaders. Good leaders listen well. And when they listen well, they are able to lead people better. And so as a mother or as a parent, I would like to encourage you. You can plan this. Plan weekly, once a week, or more than that, 3 times a week, time together, just to listen to each other. Update, what's happening to you? What are some things we can pray for you? What are some things the Lord has been doing in your life? And then as you listen to each other, plan, schedule it. Monday, MWF. Let us be intentional. I know that I have to learn more on this. Kay kabalugid ko nga siguro ang anak ko, damo siya sa, nagkaroon siya ng mga problems, sa iban siya nag-share. Kay basiway ko sang time. Kay busy kami. So we have learned that we have to really plan. We have to be intentional in building relationships through good listening.
Yeah, when it comes to listening, ako naman ang gusto ko i-encourage nga i-cultivate gid naton is the art of listening to God. Listening to God. Once we know this discipline of listening to God, I think it would be easier for us to learn to listen to people. Once we are able to capture this relationship with God that cultivates listening, no? How do you listen to God? First, of course, you have to slow down your pace. Isa the reason why kita time mamati sa Ginoo kay perti ka sako mo. Sako, busy ala, appointment to pakatuto, why katapusan nga ano. So, slow down, that's the first S. The second S is be silent. How can you hear if you keep talking? Sometimes kita ganin, no? Even in prayer. Amo na nga ito nga concept sa prayer. So, ma-pray ko, mangayo ko sa Ginoo, hambal, hala, hambal, hambal, hambal. Tanan nga mga sama-sama ng loob, ihambal, tanan nga mga kabalaka, ihambal. Pero wala aga pamati.
Isa pa nami-nami pa words, no? Kung public nga pag-prayer, pa nami-nami nga words.
Oo. Yeah, sometimes when our prayer is public, we try to, sa ibang ganiyan, prayer nila, isulat pa. Para maano, di okay man akong pang TV, pang radio, kung saan pa, meant to be printed, alimbawa, no? Galing kay line ng spontaneous nga speaking and listening to God than trying to script everything. Kasi kung scripted, para ka lang yung artista nga nag-act out ka lang sa imong role. Well, we are thankful for this time that we have shared with you. Lipot lang atong time, no? I'd like to thank my wife, Eleanor, for being with me
thank
today.
Thank you, sister.
And salamat sa inyo man nga time nga namati ka mo. I hope nga nakabulig man sa inyo. Kung kamo may gusto man niyambal sa amon, feel free to get in touch with us. There is that phone, that is number that's being flashed on the screen. You connect with us so we will also hear what you have to say. So madamo gid salamat sa inyong time. Kabay pa nga ang Ginoo magapakamaayo gid sa aton nga tanan. Happy listening, not only to the music you like to listen, but most especially, listen to God, listen to the family members, listen to your friends. We will learn more, so much more, if we listen twice than we speak. God bless us all.